Hello, dudes and nuts, and welcome back to Fallout 4. When last left off, we had investigated this brewery over here, and not a whole lot of stuff in it. I got this cool little thing that gave me the ability to make fences for the home, but that's about it. Other than that, there's not a whole lot to this place. Actually, I didn't notice a back door before. Oh. That's because I can't go through it. Alright, that's cool. What was that? Oh, it's just part of the music. Okay. That's kind of weird. Let's see. I don't think there's anything else to this place, but I don't want to, like, say there's nothing else here and then give up and wind up missing out on probably a weapon that's only over here. That looks interesting. Let's, oh, shit. I did not notice that dog there. Ooh, it's an alpha. Ooh. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Oh, no. I'm out of ammo. Ah! Yeah, I can't deal with this dog! I don't have that much health, man. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. Ow, 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 ow. Ow. Move. Jump. Come on, do something. Oh, this isn't good. Did I not get radiated? I didn't get radiated. That's awesome. Okay, can't at least do that much. Nice, I'm not getting radiated. It's like a Christmas miracle. It's not even Christmas yet. Yo, dude, what were you doing way over there? Dog meat would have been all over that freaking dog. Alright, I want to see what's over there. Looks like some sort of construction place. I'm not too sure. It looks kind of like low res. Okay, well, whatever. Switch back to the gun. Just keep on going this way until we hit what's over here. Oberlin Station.
Everyone was willing to pick up a rifle and protect his neighbor. Raiders wouldn't stand a chance.
Let's get some water. I don't even understand how this really works. Like, do I put, like, a pot underneath? What? How do... I just don't understand. How does this work? You aren't allied with this settlement. Oh! Oh, this is a settlement. Okay. of course. Hello.
Excuse me.
Very small settlement here.
Did the Minutemen send you?
Sure did.
Of course. Just tell me what you need help with.
There's a group of raiders that won't leave us alone. Stealing our food and supplies and threatening us if we can't give them what they want. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand up to them ourselves.
Any idea how many raiders we're talking about?
No telling, I'm afraid. This time there were three. But who knows how many are back at their base.
Three? Ah, alright. I'll take care of them. This will be easy. I can kill them in like 5 seconds. Alright, just need to check out the map. That one's right next to Diamond City, huh? Awesome. Backstreet Apparel. Awesome. Sounds like my place to shop. What's this over here? It looks really weird. Yeah, I'm kind of surprised I can't, like, take any of these mushrooms, do anything with them. It'd be really interesting if I could. Maybe I can make, like, some sort of strange thing out of them. Thought you could sneak up on me. Oh, God! They did! Oh man, Mr. Gutsy's here. Okay, I need to save. Where is he at? I must be heading away from him. Where is he? There he is.
A mandatory curfew is in effect.
Curfew?
By order of Provisional Governor Grant, a state of martial law has been declared. Under the terms of the Martial Law Act, Section 12.J, those refusing to comply with a curfew order are to be pacified. Repeat, will you comply?
All right, I'm going.
Cooperation acknowledged. Thank you.
Alright, here's what we're gonna do. These things are tough.
Do you have a minute?
Sure.
What is it?
When we first met, I admit, I had my doubts about you, but you've done nothing but impress me. You're just who the Minutemen needed to bring us back from the brink.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you.
You've probably realized by now how important the Minutemen are to me. When I was a kid, the Minutemen were my heroes. They were the only good guys around, really. When I turned 17, I joined up with Ezra Hollis's company. He was one of the good ones. Really believed in the old-time Minuteman way. We had a few good years there. I felt like I was part of something bigger than me. Like I was really helping make the Commonwealth a better place.
It sounds like you were really making a difference.
I think we were. I know we were, but obviously it didn't last. I'm sure there was a lot I didn't see or know enough to pay attention to. You know, the politics and rivalries and bad blood between the different groups. I guess General Becker was able to keep a lid on it, keep everyone more or less on the same team. But after he was killed, it all came out in the open. I couldn't believe it at first. These guys were supposed to be Minutemen. They were supposed to put their duty to the people ahead of everything else. You probably think I was pretty naive, huh? I guess I was. Still am, too. Even after everything, I still believe that the Minutemen can be what I always thought they were. The good guys.
We are the good guys.
We're doing our best. And a lot of it has to do with your example. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, thanks. Anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
Anytime, Preston.
Thanks, man. We probably better get back to it.
Yep, we have a Mr. Gutsy to kill. Let's see. His weakness seems to be... Wow, he's level 22. This could be a problem. Do I have any grenades equipped? I mean, that might explain a bit. There we go. Throw it. Ow. Oh my god, I'm almost dead. Ow, Jesus Christ. That really, really hurt. Maybe I should have used my AI. I should have, like, used my nuclear warhead rocket launcher. I'm gonna switch to it. Inventory. Whoop, wrong thing. There we go, Fat Man.
Alright, I'm going.
Cooperation acknowledged.
You're very welcome, Mr. Gutsy. Let's see, I need to hit him. Ooh, boy. That was something. Alright. Anything else over here? I just really wanted to blow that Mr. Gutsy up. Kinda cause I'm still super angry about that other time that Mr. Gutsy killed me. One less Mr. Gutsy in the world means one less stress for me. Looks like you kinda cleared out somebody's home. Alright, so we're done here. That was cool. But I really want to check out what the heck this thing is. It looks like I'm pretty close to it. I'm gonna quickly save. There we go. Whoa. Preston. Where'd Preston go? Preston. Preston? He didn't get... Oh, there you are.
Do you have a minute?
Yes.
Sure. Go ahead.
When we first met, I... But you...
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you.
You've probably... We had a...
Uh-huh. It sounds like you were really making a difference.
I think we were.
All right. Just kind of quickly go through all this.
You probably think I still...
Sure. We are the good guys.
We're doing our best. Anyway.
Uh-huh. Anytime, Preston.
Thanks, man. We probably better get back to it.
Yep. All right. It's over this way. Seems kind of interesting. Okay, yeah, that's probably something for another time. Looks like there's a lot there. So, yeah. Let's take care of that at another point. Alright, so, let's keep on moving towards this gear-shaped thing. Is it a vault? I bet it's a vault. Oh man, I'm kind of excited. Oh man. Oh man. Oh man, it's a vault, isn't it? Wait, what is that thing? Looks like a bear. Oh god, it's like a werebear! Kill the werebear! Oh my god! Oh my god, it's not having any of this! Switch to the shotgun now. Oh my god, I gotta sneeze. Oh, I'm sorry, I just like sneezed right into the mic. Oh my god, no! Oh, I missed. Oh my god, where's Preston? I need him to distract the werebear! Ah! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Give me all that junk. Oh my god! Vault 81. Alright. Ooh. Has a searchlight on it. It's a cave. Ooh, I'm excited. Okay. This vault doesn't really have a vault to it, does it? Oh, now I see.
Those vaults, like you came out of, right?
Yep, that's right. Crispy squirrel bits. Blast Radius board game.
What are you gonna do with that?
I don't know, probably play some games with it. What else are you gonna do with a board game? Also, it has nuclear material. Might as well do something with it, right? Alright, now let's activate it. Boop.
Hold it right there. Vault 81 security. I don't know where you got your hands on a working pit boy, but you better start talking.
I got it in Vault 111.
Vault 111? Haven't heard of that one yet. And what sort of business are you looking to take care of here in 81?
I'm just a traveler. I thought I'd take a look around.
Is that so? And you expect me to believe that? Oh, Overseer.
Who is it, Edwards?
Ma'am, some new Commonwealth traveler. Not one of our usual traders.
Well, if someone wants in, they can earn it like everyone else. Let me speak to them. Sorry about that. Officer Edwards here was just doing his job. I'm sure you can understand our need for caution. For newcomers, we like to operate on exchange. You help us, we help you.
I'm interested. What is it you need?
Fusion cores. 3, to be exact.
That's exactly how many I have. Alright.
I already have the fusion cores you need.
Really? Well then, I suppose I should say welcome. I'll be down to meet you at the entrance.
Oh my god. Oh, there's so many fusion cores. This is kind of cool. Like, meeting other vault dwellers.
Come on, Gwen. My guys have been working doubles for weeks now. They need a break.
Everyone's working hard right now, Cal. You think I don't know that? Just do the best with what you can.
Wow. This vault's a lot cleaner than the one I was in.
I'll see what I can do. But you and I both know we can't keep going on like this.
Sorry about that. As you'll soon see, we have a few maintenance projects underway. Gwen McNamara, Overseer. Welcome to Vault 81. Here, we pride ourselves on having maintained a successful vault over these past 2 centuries. We'd like to be completely self-sufficient, but there are certain resources we can't provide ourselves.
I'm impressed you maintained a successful vault for so long.
Thanks. I owe it to the overseers before me, but some here would disagree. A few believe opening the doors to the Commonwealth was a mistake.
Hmm.
You should be wary. The Commonwealth is a dangerous place.
Exactly why we rely on a select few traders for our needs. That's why I like to use a give-and-take system. If outsiders are willing to help us, we're willing to help them. Speaking of, if you're ready, I can take those fusion cores from you.
Here you go. I'm sure you'll put them to good use.
I won't, but Dr. Penske certainly will. Now, I have work to do.
Ma'am, what about his friend here?
I'll allow it. Security is already extra mindful as it is. If he's lived this long in the Commonwealth, I'm sure he's chosen his friends wisely. If you need anything else, I'll be in my office.
Don't go feeling all special because the Overseer let you in here. You weren't the first, and certainly won't be the last.
Interesting.
Power noodles. Our chef only says one sentence, but that's okay, because he only serves one thing. Are you a pistol-packing mama?
Let's go talk to people. Neil.
Hey there.
Wow, you're just like string bean.
Visitor today. Don't say anything, but man, I'd love to be out there.
It takes some preparation. I'd learn how to use a gun and be ready to use it before I went out there.
I've never even touched a gun. Now, I can't even say if our security has seen any real combat, but with the hours we're working these days, I'm not even sure where I'd find the time to practice.
Hard work pays off, and you guys are maintaining the vault, right?
Trying to, at least. They say it's all the moving parts that have us working round the clock these days. Structurally, I guess 81 is still pretty sound. Vault Tech sure knew what they were doing when they set these places up. Well, I don't want to keep you, and I gotta get back to work. Maybe I'll see you around.
Ooh, that's a cool looking chair. Kinda want one.
Another outsider? What'd they let you in for?
Just taking a look around.
Is the Overseer just letting anyone in these days?
I'm a fellow Vault Dweller.
I don't care where you're from. It's not here.
Wow. I don't really like you, Miranda.
Don't try it.
If only the Commonwealth wasn't so dangerous, I'd love to see more of it.
Requires terminal. Okay.
No signs of radiation. Impressive.
Hey, Ashes.
A kitty!
Ashes, where are you going? Ash! Damn it. Aaron's not going to
let me. I want to pet the kitty! Kitty, 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 kitty. Get back here, kitty. Where are you going, kitty? No, kitty, don't! Kitty! Oh no, don't, no! Oh no. Sorry, your cat's kind of like,
Is that your pit boy? Better be.
Pardon me, officer.
Watch yourself.
Let's see. Not really sure what I want to do here. I mean, I'm not gonna go around causing trouble.
See Horatio while you're here. Can't imagine you come across many barbers in the Commonwealth.
Barber?
I don't want to hear any negative reports about you, outsider.
Hi.
Now that you made it in, we'll be keeping an eye on you. So do us all a favor and behave yourself.
Will do. Alright. So, I say go see a barber. So I'm gonna go visit the barber. What, no lights in this elevator? What the heck? It's so dark. Oh, there you are, Preston. Alright. It kind of weirds me out how they, like, just spawn in there like that.
Hey, mister, are you really from the Commonwealth?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
I knew it! Hey, I can show you around the vault if you want. Just 5 caps.
Okay, show me around.
Okay, give me the tour, Austin. Here's the caps.
Yes! I gotta show you to Erin. She's gonna flip. Follow me. We'll start over here.
Hello, resident. What's this place?
This is the depot. The Combs family run it. Aaron and I are best friends. Her mom and dad fight a lot, so I don't like to go in there when they're around. But if you need something, they're the ones that have it.
Alright, that's kind of cool.
What do they fight about?
I shouldn't tell you this, but everyone says Mr. Combs is sleeping with Tina. Mrs. Combs doesn't know, but he's always leaving her to do all the work while he hangs out with Tina. Next stop, the Overseer. I bet you killed a lot of strange things. Ooh, and raiders. I bet you fought raiders too.
Yep, that's exactly what I was about to do before I stopped by here. All right, is this like the Overseer's office? Okay.
They're busy up there, and they do not like to be bothered.
I'd imagine.
But she's nice. I like her.
Does she take care of people that break the rules?
Security mostly takes care of the people who break the rules, but she's in charge of all of the security officers. It doesn't happen very often. Next stop, the diner. Now we gotta go downstairs. That's where the diner is. Everybody eats there. Sometimes it gets real crowded. The Somersets are nice, though.
How many people are down here? Very impressive.
Hello, Austin. I see you're showing our guest from the Commonwealth around.
Yes, ma'am. This is the Sunshine Diner. Grant says that they'll take all of our hard work and turn it into swill. Mr. and Mrs. Somerset run the diner. They're pretty nice. Mrs. Somerset's pies are the best.
How's their food? Other than the pies.
I like it. Mrs. Somerset always sneaks me second.
I'll save you a slice of pie, Austin.
Next stop, Horatio.
Aha, I need to go visit him.
Nice. Do you like your hair? I like mine. I hate combing it, though. Gran makes me comb it.
The barber. Awesome.
Austin, that hair of yours is a mole rat's nest.
Yes, it's where Horatio fixes up people's hair. Aaron's mom comes here all the time. Gran hardly comes here at all. She makes me cut my hair, though. It's not fair.
Would he do my hair?
Sure. He can turn your hair into anything. I wanted him to make mine look like Skull, but Gran wouldn't let me. Next stop, it's Gran. Let's go see Gran.
Now, if only I could find a tattooer.
Nice.
Nice. Although, I'd kind of rather not have a facial tattoo. I'd rather have, like, a regular arm tattoo or something like that. Ooh. Awesome.
Hi, Gran.
Austin, what are you doing here? Are you bothering that stranger from the Commonwealth?
I'm not bothering him. I'm helping him. That's Gran. She takes care of me. You can call her Dr. Penske. She acts a little grumpy, but it's not for real. She runs our hydroponics lab. It's where we get all our food.
Dude, your hair is glowing.
You don't get anything from the Commonwealth?
Nope. Gran grows it all year. She's really smart. Next stop, Miss Katie.
But why do you have, like, mutated corn and carrots and all that?
Gotta go to the other side of the vault. I'll show you where I go to school. I bet you.
Oh, shit, that thing got knocked over. Whoops. Alright, dude, lead the way. I'm building something new here.
This is the school. Miss Katie runs it. It's boring most of the time, but Gran says I have to go anyway.
Your Gran is a smart woman, Austin.
Are there a lot of kids in the vault?
Not that many. The overseer says that we're using population control, whatever that is. Next stop is the medical clinic. Let's go downstairs.
Awesome, I need to go to the medical clinic.
Forsyth and Rachel are okay, I guess. But I don't go there unless I have to. Or unless Grant makes me.
Wow, that's some awesome balance, Austin. I wonder if I named my character Austin, if he'd get, like, super excited.
This is our medical clinic. If you get hurt or sick, come down here. Dr. Forsythe says I can't bother him or Rachel while they're working.
Did you ever get sick?
Just colds and stuff. Hardly anyone here gets sick. Mr. Somerset broke his foot.
Where did he come from?
Cast on it, and he had to walk with crutches. Now we go see Erin. She's gonna be surprised when she sees you. Come on, this way.
All right, that's all awesome and stuff.
Welcome, welcome.
Didn't believe me when I said I would bring you to her.
I hope I'm not being presumptuous, but I'd like to ask you a favor. Would you mind donating the samples, even just the blood sample?
Sure, you can have some blood.
Excellent. Just have a seat. And I'll draw some blood.
All right, let's sit down.
This will only take a sec.
I hope you do know my blood's radiated.
There. Hardly hurt a bit, eh? Thank you. This will be a great help. Now, I need to get these prepared immediately.
Excuse me, Dr. Forsythe.
Doctor? Okay, fine. Doctor.
That wanderer from the Commonwealth. I'm Rachel. I assist Dr. Forsythe with his medical duties. Are you sick or injured?
Yes, in fact, I am.
Hello, Rachel.
Feeling all right? I can always take a look.
Yeah. Take a look at me, Doc.
Go over your symptoms with me.
Cure rads.
I think I soaked up some rads out there.
Blood pooling in the gums. Signs of anemia. Yeah, we better clean you up.
Oh my god, thank you, Rachel. I love you so much.
All done. Any other complaints?
Nah, good.
We're done.
Off you go, then.
I don't think I have any chem addictions, so... Alright. Now to follow, where'd he go? Nah, it's probably not it.
Work never ends in Vault 81.
Let's see. Oh, wait. I better, There we go.
Everything's under control.
Where'd that kid go? I'm not really sure.
Hold up, Austin.
How do you like the tour so far?
It's great. Keep going.
See? I knew you'd like it.
Hello, Katie.
Oh, you're that new traveler. You must have had so many adventures out in the Commonwealth.
Sure I did.
Every waking moment's an adventure out there.
Oh my. I knew it. My kids would love to hear some of them. Would you be willing to talk to my class?
Ah, sure thing.
I'd be glad to talk to them.
Marvelous. Stop by whenever class is in session.
Class isn't in session right now?
I'll turn the class over to you.
Hey, Katie.
This will be a rare treat for the kids. I'm looking forward to what you'll have to say.
All right, I don't know how to...
Bottomless pit when it comes to food.
I don't know how to, activate this.
Hello, Katie.
The children will be very excited to hear about the Commonwealth.
Hold up, Austin.
Are you glad I'm showing you all this stuff?
It's great. Keep going.
See? I knew you'd like it.
Is class in session right now?
Well, hello.
I wish my mom wasn't working so much.
Hey, pal.
Hello.
I
can't wait till I don't have to go to school anymore.
Well, I was actually kind of looking forward to being introduced to this Aaron character, but I don't think that's going to happen. Whoa. Uh-oh, someone is using some jet. I honestly assumed that the doors would just stay open. That'd probably be why I kind of like lost him. Are you Aaron?
Whoa! A real live Commonwealth person! You dress funny.
Well, hello.
I wish my mom and dad wouldn't fight so much. Talk to my mom if you want something fixed.
All right. Well, that was cool. Yeah, that's a shame. Man, that poor kid actually just like feel bad for her right now. Like her parents are constantly fighting and now she just lost her cat.
Stop by. Now I know from experience that Commonwealth shows no mercy when it comes to hair. So, how about a trim?
Sure.
Sounds good.
All right. Let's see what the Commonwealth has to work with. Just have a seat.
That shouldn't be too bad. I keep my hair clean. Let's go with a new style. Never mind. I don't know why that looked, like, kind of different. Why is it, like, changing? That's so weird. If I can get my hair to change to, like, say, blue, I'd be very... very happy. Actually, I was like, meh.
New style, new you. What do you say?
Alright.
You've been outside of the vault?
Quincy, born and raised. My mother, may she rest in peace. She was a doctor. Imagine her surprise when she learned I'd rather cut hair than stitch people up. But enough about me. How about that hair of yours?
Did you say you were from Quincy?
Sure did. Looks like I was one of the lucky ones, too. Last I heard, gunners had taken her over.
What's the word around Vault 81?
They say Holt is running around on his wife. Apparently, he and Tina DeLuca are secretly getting together.
Gasp.
Never mind about them. Your hair is a disaster.
Didn't you just fix it, though?
You have to let me fix it.
All right.
No. God dang it. No. I just paid for it. God dang it. All right. So, I will continue on next time, and looks like we're kind of, like, done here. So, I'll continue along next time with taking out those raiders. But until then, please like and favorite, please share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe on the Cerebral of Cerebral Games. Signing off.